Welcome to the another class. In this class, we will discuss about the hormonal control of insect metamorphosis. So this work was majorly contributed by Sir Vincent Inglesworth. So he is the person who has worked on the hormonal control of insect metamorphosis, especially arthropoda metamorphosis. So in this, we will be seeing that how different hormones play an important role in the during the metamorphosis process. So there are two major hormones which we will be seeing that they will play an important role in the conversion of one form to the other form. The one hormone is the juvenile hormone, which is represented as a JH. The other hormone is ecdysone. So the active form of the ecdysone is 20-hydroxy ecdysone. So these are produced at different places in the brain region. So there are the cells in the brain which are called neurosecretory cells. So there are basically three types of cells are present apart from endocrine glands. They are neurosecretory cells, endocrine glands and neurohemal glands. So these are three structures which are responsible for the production of various hormones which are responsible for the metamorphosis process. So these neurosecretory cells, which will be the under the influence of environmental conditions, stress and hormonal regulation, will be secreting a hormones which will stimulate a structure called corpora cardiaca. This is a structure which comes under the neurohemal structure. This is present in the brain region, and upon the stimulus on this corpora cardiaca, it will be producing a hormone called prothoracicotropic hormone, which is represented as PTTH. And this prothoracicotropic hormone is released into the blood circulation, and once they are released into the blood circulation, they act upon the prothoracic gland. And this prothoracic gland, upon the activation by the PTTH, will produce the moulting hormone, which is known as ecdysone. And this ecdysone again will be coming into the circulation and reaches to the peripheral tissue wherever the metamorphosis is happening. So in peripheral tissue, they will be converting into a 20-hydroxy ecdysone. This is the active form of a ecdysone hormone, and this is the one which is playing an important role in during the metamorphosis process, from larval to larval structure, from larval to pupal structure, and pupal to the adult structure. So the major player over this conversion from one form to the other form is due to the 20-hydroxy ecdysone. So there is another neurohemal structure which is called as a corpora aleta. Corpora aleta is just present just behind the corpora cardiaca in the brain region. This is also under the influence of the neurosecretory cells, will be producing a hormone called as a juvenile hormone. And this will be essential. This hormone will be playing an important role in conversion of one larval form to the other larval form. Say suppose here you can see that larva is converting into a pupal form. So these two regulation, the hormone, the juvenile hormone and as well as the 20-hydroxy ecdysone, both will be acting in a regulation, in a tight regulation, so that the larva doesn't convert directly into an adult, but it will be going into a subsequent stages, like larva to the next larval stage and pupal, and subsequently into the adult stage. Then one more important thing regarding the 20-hydroxy ecdysone is they will be functioning through a apolysis process. Apolysis process is a process where the cuticle, which is present in the arthropoda organism, this cuticle which is present in the larval structures, will be replaced by the new cuticle, and this is the one which helps in the moulting phenomenon. So this will help in the conversion of one stages, that larval cuticle will be converting into a pupal cuticle and subsequently to the adult cuticle. And the process, the whatever the changes which are associated with the juvenile hormone, these signals are denoted as a differentiating signals, whereas the signals which are given out by the egg dyson, they are called as a moulting signals. So moulting means from one stage to the other stage they will be moulting, and the larval will be going to the next stage and subsequently will be developing into an adult structure. Differentiating signal, this differentiating signal will help the organism to differentiate from one larval structure to the other larval structure. So if the juvenile hormone is not present, or by some way the juvenile hormone is blocked, so the larva will be not will be stays into the juvenile hormone. The larva will be staying in the larval stage only. It will not proceed in the pupal stage. And if there is a problem in the egg dyson hormone, if there is a problem in the egg dyson hormone, larva will permanently stay in the larval stages, and just they will be growing in size. So you will be having a giant larva will be arising through it. So egg dyson will be playing an important role in conversion of the larval forms into a different molting structures and pupal, and then it will go into the adult form. So this egg dyson, the 20 hydroxy egg dyson, in especially in Drosophila organisms, they will be released in two pulses. So the first pulses, they will be giving rise to the wings, leg structure, and imaginary disc cells, which are responsible for this wings and leg structures to develop. And the second pulse, which is generated in the organism, that will lead to the pre-pupal stage to the adult structure. So this is how the 20 hydroxy egg dyson is important for the conversion of one stage of the metamorphosis to the next stage of the metamorphosis. At the same time, the juvenile hormone will be initially present, which is responsible for changing from one stage to the other stage. As the juvenile hormone concentration decreases, the prothoracic hormone will be produced by corpora cardiaca, and the concentration of the egg dyson hormone will be raises. So at the same time, you will not see the concentration of the juvenile hormone and the concentration of the 20 hydroxy egg dyson hormone at the same level. Initially, in the larval stage, you will see that the concentration of the juvenile hormone is in the higher amount, and later on, as the concentration, as the cell undergoes the differentiation, the concentration of the 20 hydroxy egg dyson hormone will be raises. So this is about the importance of how these two hormones will be regulating the metamorphosis. Now it is clear that 20 hydroxy egg dyson along with juvenile hormone is important for the insect metamorphosis. So in the development of the larval stage to the adult stage, these hormones will be playing an important role. So now we will see how 20 hydroxy egg dyson is similar to the thyroid hormone, that is the active form of the thyroid hormone T3, triiodothyronine. In both the cases, this hormone which is present, they have a nuclear receptors. Like in case of 20 hydroxy egg dyson, you have a egg dyson receptor, ECRS, egg dyson receptor. In case of thyroid hormone, which we have seen in the amphibian metamorphosis, TR, thyroid hormone receptors. And in this, we have seen alpha and beta. And we know that alpha is expressed before the thyroid gland has been developed, and beta is developed under the influence of the thyroid hormone itself. So beta receptor, thyroid receptor beta, they are under the influence of the thyroid hormone. Here also you will see that these receptors which are present, they are also will be under the influence, they will be also produced under the influence of this 20 hydroxy egg dyson hormone. And other similarity which is present in case of the hormone activity is, so the hormone which is present, they will be binding to a receptor which is present in the nucleus. So this alone will not be working. They will be having a secondary receptor which will dimerize with the thyroid receptor, which is retinoid receptor in case of the amphibian metamorphosis. Here also you will see that ecdysone receptor has a one more component, one more candidate in the nucleus, which together forms the dimerization, that is ultraspiracle protein. So ultraspiracle protein along with the ecdysone receptor, they will be forming a complex, and this complex will be binding to the, or this hormone is binds to the this dimerized component. So when this hormone is not present, when this hormone is not produced, they will be binding to one more candidate, which is called E75. So E75 is a transcriptional factor which represses the activity of the gene which is assisted by this 20-hydroxy-ecdysone. So you will be having the genes named as ecdysone responsive genes. So ecdysone responsive genes will be activated upon the binding of 20-hydroxy-ecdysone to ecdysone receptor, which is dimerized with the ultraspiracle on the DNA. And once they bond, once this hormone is bound, this ecdysone receptor genes will be activated. So here also, upon binding this hormone, T3 hormone, to the thyroid receptor and retinoid receptor, you will see the thyroid hormone responsive genes will be activated. Then what else you will be seeing the differences is, this thyroid hormone, which is produced in response to various environmental factor, stress factor, and this thyroid hormone will be exhibiting a negative feedback. So excess of the thyroid hormone will be acting on the pituitary gland, and they will stop the production of the thyroid hormone by inhibiting the secretion of the TSH, that is thyroid stimulating hormone. So this is how the thyroid hormone itself will show a negative feedback inhibition. In case of 20-hydroxy-ecdysone, upon binding to ecdysone receptor ultraspiracle, they will be activating an ecdysone responsive genes. This ecdysone responsive genes are nothing but these are the transcriptional factors which will be playing an important role in the first stage, means that the primary stage of the pupil, that is larval development. Larval development from one stage to the other stage, like one instar stage to the other instar stage. So those ecdysone responsive genes, early ecdysone responsive genes are transcription factors, and this transcription factors, whatever it is present, this will be activating the next level of transcription factors, that is the late responsive transcription factors. And this subsequent activating of one transcription factor upon the other transcription factor, early transcription factor on the late transcription factor, will lead to the development of the insect, that is the larval form, when one stage to the other stage. Now I was telling that this, how this will be negatively regulated. In case of here, we have seen that the thyroid hormone itself will be showing a negative feedback inhibition upon acting on the pituitary gland, and pituitary gland will be in decreases the production of the thyroid stimulating hormone. Here also you will see that this 20-hydroxy-ecdysone, upon binding to the ecdysone receptor and ultraspiracle, they will be producing, or they will be activating a genes which is responsible for the enzymes required for degradation of the 20-hydroxy-ecdysone. So they don't inhibit at the endocrine level. They will be inhibiting directly the hormone. So this will be responsible. They themselves are responsible for activating the genes which are responsible for the degradation of the 20-hydroxy-ecdysone. So they have some activity. First activity is they will be activating its own receptors. Second, transcriptional factors, which are plays an important role in the larval development. So, first transcriptional factors which they will be, they are early responsive genes. Then, third, they will be activating the genes which will be helpful for the activating the genes which gives rise to enzyme, and this enzyme will be degrading the hormone which is produced. So this is how the 20-hydroxyhexaenzyme will be showing its effect in the initial stages. And all these effects, whatever you are seeing, that having affecting the production of the receptor, the affecting the responsive genes, transcription factor responsive genes, and the production of the enzymes which is responsible for degradation, all are very analogous. You will see that all these are analogously present in case of the thyroid hormone in amphibian metamorphosis also. So this is how you will see that 20-hydroxyhexaenzyme is playing an important role in the initial stages. So you will also see that this 20-hydroxyhexaenzyme has a sequential effect on the DNA where it is binding. So when this 20-hydroxyhexaenzyme was incubated with the chromosome of salivary gland drosophila, salivary gland of the drosophila, they have found that, so salivary gland chromosome of the drosophila is known as the polytiny chromosomes. They have observed that upon addition of this 20-hydroxyhexaenzyme, the chromosome has given puff-like structures. So this is a chromosome. They have given a puff-like structures, which they have called as a chromosomal puffs. And these chromosomal puffs are a indicator of that activity, that is the chromosomally it is expressed, active. That is, they are expressing actively at this stage. So that is the reason the DNA, the chromosome which is present there, they loosen and they will expose the DNA over that place, and those places where the DNA is loosened, their active transcription will be taken. So transcriptionally active sites they are. Then what they have observed is wherever this ectasin is added to the salivary gland chromosomes, these puffs which are forming, they are forming in a sequential way. Like once the puff was forming, the chromosomal puffs, that is the transcriptionally active sites are formed. These transcriptionally active sites will, after some times, they will be repressed. So these repressed active sites of the chromosome, active sites of the transcription, will lead to the active formation of the new puffs at a different locations. New puffs. So what it indicates from it is the first transcriptionally active genes, that is responsible for the formation of the newer puffs in the other location. So one is one first chromosomal puff is responsible for the secondary chromosomal puffs formation. So this is one indicator that how the one responsive genes, that is the ectasin responsive genes, is responsible for the activating a cascade of subsequent responsive genes. Early responsive genes activating the cascade of late responsive genes. So the insect is developing from the larval stage to the pupal stage, and from pupal stage to the adult stage. So in this will be helping. And this is how the ectosome will be acting, and in detail I will be telling you little later. So the other hormone, which is known as juvenile hormone, will be acting exactly opposite of the 20-hydroxyectisone. So this will help in the development of the larval stage to go into the next larval stage. So when this concentration is present in high amount, the larval form will be moulting, but it will give rise to a next larval stage with a larger body size, more segment will be present. If juvenile hormone is not present, or juvenile hormone is present in excess and 20-hydroxyectisone hormone is absent, at that time the larval stage will not develop into an adult organism. Instead, the larval stage will develop into a giant larval form. So this is how the juvenile hormone is important, as well as 20-hydroxyectisone hormone is will be playing important role. See, this juvenile hormone will be acting via MET protein, and this MET protein will be inhibiting the broad complex. This is also one of the transcription factors which will play important role in the apoptosis process, and it is activated, so it is inhibited. So it is, it inhibits this MET protein, will inhibit this broad complex, and this broad complex is activated by this 20-hydroxyectisone plus ectisone receptor, then you have ultraspathic. So this is how the juvenile hormone will be contracting the activity of the ectisone hormone, and ectisone hormone how it will be acting upon the changes, means how it is initiated in initiates the various cellular process, and it will be helping in the transcription expression of the early transcription factor, early responsive transcription factor, which will leads to the activation of the subsequent transcription factor. So in this picture we will see how the ectisone hormone activates early responsive genes. So ectisone coupled with ectisone receptor and ultraspherical protein, this complex is responsible for activating the early responsive genes, that is E74, E75. Apart from that, they will also activate ectisone receptor and broad complex, which is not shown here. So it will also activate ectisone receptor and broad complex. So this early responsive genes, this will be activating the second set of genes like E75, DHR4, DHR3. So the second set of genes in turn will be inhibiting the early responsive genes. Here you can see they are activated, these genes are activated, and this in turn are inhibiting the early responsive genes. So these genes are nothing but a transcriptional factors, E74, E75, E75, these are the transcriptional factor. Now what this DHR4, DHR3 will be doing, they will be coordinating the growth and behavior of the larval forms, growth and the behavior of the larval forms. Apart from that, the early responsive genes will also responsible for inhibiting a gene called beta FTZF1. So this is a fusiterazo protein which plays an important role in
in the second pulse of the ecdysone receptor. So whenever the second pulse of the ecdysone receptor is present, at that time they is responsible for activating a different set of the genes. So all this helps in this early gene responsive genes and later gene responsive genes. These are all responsible for the development of the larva. So the development from the one instar stage to the next instar stage. See, here you can see third instar stage to the pupal stage. So development of the instar stage to the pupal stage, this one set of protein will be activating the other set of the protein, which you will see in case of polytiny chromosomal puffs also, that one puff is activated the other puff formation. So this is how the cascades will be regulated. Early responsive genes will be regulating the next set of the genes. At the same time, 20E, the active form of the ecdysone, will also binds to ecdysone receptor A. This is the isoform of the ecdysone receptor. There are different isoforms of ecdysone receptors are present. Ecdysone receptor A, ecdysone receptor B1, ecdysone receptor B2. This all will be playing a different roles. So they will be activating a transcriptional factors, different set of transcriptional factors, broad complex E74, E75. They will be helping in inducing a apoptosis promoter proteins. So they are called Reaper and Hint. So these are the apoptosis inducer proteins. So what the function of this is, they will be assisting in the death of the larval salivary glands. Similarly, E75 transcriptional factor will be inhibiting the DAP2, which will inhibit the larval structures from the death. So it is a regulatory phenomenon in which the same set of transcriptional factors which are activated by this series will be acting as an inhibitor and also acting as an initiator of the apoptosis process. So we have seen that how the ecdysone is promoting the different metamorphosis stages in the Drosophila organism. We'll see how the metamorphosis changes which are assisted by the ecdysone hormone is blocked by the juvenile hormone. Juvenile hormone will be activating a protein which is called KRH1. This in turn will be inhibiting the broad complex. So broad complex is here, you can see in the broad complex is responsible for the induction of the apoptosis. So apoptosis will be inhibited. So 20E is acting upon the broad complex and will be inducing the apoptosis. So that apoptosis will be inhibited by the juvenile hormone. So juvenile hormone is indirectly acting on the broad product. So broad transcription factor. So this broad transcription factor upon inhibition will be committed from larval to the pupal commitment will be established. So this is how the two hormones, that is the ecdysone hormone and the juvenile hormone, will be regulating the changes from the larval stage to the pupal stage and pupal stage to the adult stage. So directly the larval stage will not be jumping to the adult stage. The reason for that is they will be having a concentration of the juvenile hormone as well as the ecdysone hormone. Active form of the ecdysone hormone are in the balanced tight regulation, and this helps in the development of the organism through the metamorphosis process. This is how the hormonal regulation in insect metamorphosis is occurring. Thank you.